I would like to tell a rather unusual tale that happened to me this morning, early in the morning, around 7 o'clock. It's just so utterly absurd that I had to share it with you all out there and give you some further idea about that which I'm dealing at this point in time. So, anyway, I decided to go for a walk before leaving the house this morning. I go one street up, and as I'm turning the corner on that street and start walking down it, I see a red Chrysler kind of moving back and forth, deciding whether or not it's going to pull out of the driveway where it had been sitting. Kind of, it looked like stationed there waiting for any activity, for, you know, me to move or go somewhere, kind of watching me. And so I turn the corner, and this red Chrysler finally pulls out. You know, after a couple seconds of that, the red Chrysler pulls out. I see at that point in time that it's a woman, some blonde woman, maybe 45 years old, wearing too much makeup, kind of bitchy looking as well. She drives by, and then she gives me a fake smile and waves, and I just kind of, you know, she looked like a perp to me, so I just kind of scowled, didn't wave back, because I don't really like perps, and she gave me the perp vibe, right? And so I keep walking. I watch some guy take his golf swing, and I walk down probably another 100 yards, and I realize I have forgotten my cigarettes. And so the cigarette I was smoking was my last one, and I didn't want to walk much further without any cigarettes, so I decided to turn around. And I turned around, and I had watched this woman turn off on the main road, the one that I had walked in from, and it looked like she left. But then when I turn around, this woman is sitting three houses down from the driveway she had been sitting in before, and she's doing the same thing, except, you know, it's more pronounced this time, kind of going back and forth behind this bush, you know, obviously watching me. And I'm like, what the fuck? So I keep walking the same, you know, I've turned back around. I'm going back the way I came at this point in time. As I keep walking towards the car, as I approach and get closer, she finally pulls out of that driveway and then drives toward me, stops right next to me, rolls down her window and asks me if I'm lost. And I said, no, are you? Then she asked me if I live around here. And I said, yeah, I live around here. And then she asked me where. And then I told her, it's none of your business. Because, you know, I've had people who have been threatening to... I didn't tell her this, but I didn't want to tell her where I live. Because, A, it's none of her business. And, B, people have been threatening to kill me. And they seem to be in league with the perps who are on the street stalking me. So I didn't really want to divulge that information to that woman. It's none of her business. It's, you know, it's not her job to watch me. If she's so worried about her property, then she can, or her safety or whatever, she can do like I do and fucking live in someone's basement, emerging very infrequently. But she's, her and her type of people are the reason I'm living that way right now. Because I'm being stalked by a bunch of assholes who have been paid, who have been roped into participating in this program by the state. And she's one of them. At that point in time, it's obvious. So I told her it's none of her business. She rolls up her window and figure that's the end of it. And so then I get back out onto the main street, and then I come back to my street. And I can see this woman in between these houses, and she's just sitting there watching me, you know, and kind of like creeping her car along forward. So I shrug my shoulders at her, and like, what the hell are you doing? Why are you stalking me? Why are you watching me? And she just continues to sit there and creeping along. So I flip her the bird at that point in time. I gave her the finger. Freaking sick of this shit. So I did. I flipped her the bird. She deserved it. Her actions were out of line and definitely deserved the finger. I'm sorry. You know, sometimes somebody deserves the finger. She's one of those people. So anyway, she's still watching me. So I figure, you know what? I'm not going to walk to my house at this point in time. So I keep walking. I walk past my house. I walk up to a nearby street, and that street kind of goes down, and so you become, you know, you'd be no longer visible from the street. So I figured she was going to pull up and see where I was going. So I was sitting there facing the street that I just come off of. I'm sitting there waiting for her to pull up like I knew she was going to do. And sure enough, she does. She pulls up and I wave to her like, what are you doing? She drove off real quick. So I figure I'm still not going home. This woman's probably still watching me. So I decided to go walk even further. So I continue heading in the same direction I was. I get off the road that kind of goes downhill. I go back out on the main road, you know, continue heading away from my house into a neighborhood that's further up the street. And I can see that the neighborhood that I'm going to is on the left, and she's sitting in a neighborhood that's on the right hand side, just kind of pretending like she's going to pull out. She's just sitting there like she's going to pull out, but she's just sitting there watching me. And so there's a cop that lives up in the neighborhood that I'm walking in at this point in time, try and kill some time and see if this woman will leave me alone and like go about her day like she should have done to begin with. She's sitting there watching me. So I point to the cop car that's sitting in front of this person's house, and I say, I'm going to go knock on his door, kind of. And, you know, I was thinking about it, but I figure the police already hate me enough, so I'm not going to go wake one of them up on their day off or whatever. I didn't. I walked past it. I stop. I kind of pause in front of the house. She's still sitting there. She's not worried. I think the whole ploy was to, like, try and, you know, make me do something stupid. But I didn't, you know, unless you consider flipping somebody off who's acting in this ridiculous manner, stupid, which I don't. I think it's justified and warranted. So I continue walking. I go kind of walk around the circle out onto a different road where I was invisible to her. I was behind some houses for a period of time, and so I figured maybe she's driven off at this point in time. So I come out. Nope, she's still sitting there. So I'm walking towards that main road, and then finally, as I get close to her again, she takes off, and this time it looks like she's going to leave, right? So then at that point in time, I start walking back towards my house, and then, nope, she must have turned around, and then falls in behind me. It's like parked probably a quarter of a mile away watching me, and then, you know, as I'd advance further away from her, she would creep forward and then park, you know, always trying to maintain that quarter of a mile distance from me. And then finally I get to, you know, kind of a man-made structure that gives me the opportunity to kind of like escape. So I duck out behind this man-made structure, and then I start doubling back on her, you know, and I'm invisible at this point in time. She can't see me from her location, so I'm trying to double back. By the time I reemerged, she was gone. And then when I come back onto the main street, kind of I doubled back where she was parked. She's gone, but all these perps, these red cars are driving past looking at me. You know, the people in their car, red cars, people wearing red shirts are driving by me, like obviously keeping tabs of my location. So these people know where I live already. This was a bunch of bullshit. It was designed to annoy, harass, and get me to do something stupid. It was just a more in-your-face tactic, it looks like, to try and get me to act out. Well, you know what? I'm free to flip somebody off who's stalking me, and I'm free to tell somebody who's asking me questions on the street to go to hell, and it's none of their business. The woman was acting inappropriately, this middle-aged woman acting completely inappropriately, completely harassing me when I'm trying to take an early morning walk and get some exercise. So that's where I'm at. I can't even like leave my house without these people following me. And this time, like, just blatantly harassing me. It's a pretty funny story. It's where we're at in our society. People aren't free to go about their day. And people who should have better things to do, the people who are, you know, driving around in nice cars, you know, pretending to be upstanding pillars of the community with something better to do, apparently don't have anything better to do. They can follow someone around all day long. This went on for about an hour. This me walking away from her and her following me went on for over an hour. And it started getting hot, and when I got home, I was, you know, pretty sweaty from walking around. I really wasn't planning on taking that far of a walk. I hadn't slept. I was kind of tired. And, you know, when I was doubling back and taking the path to double back on her, I fell in some rocks. Can't get away from these people. They're fucking ridiculous. They ought to be ashamed of themselves. They're embarrassing. They're embarrassing to me. Like, I'm embarrassed for them. Like, who the hell would do this and think that this kind of activity is okay? It's okay to treat another person like this. I was waiting for the cops to show up during the event here. I figured she was like, we'd call the cops and tell them something stupid, like I flipped her off. The cops would, you know, I was actually kind of hoping they would show up so I could flip them off too. Tell them, look, I'm not doing anything wrong here. I'm not going to give you my name. I'm not doing anything criminal. I'm walking down the street minding my own business. You need to get a handle of your citizen stooges that you're using to harass law-abiding citizens. You know, that's what you need to do. You need to cut the crap in these community policing programs where you're giving these mental midgets some iota of power and they are abusing that, what little power they have. I mean, this just goes to show you, you don't give power-hungry people and idiots, you know, mental midgets, the kind of power that you're giving these people, because they're, you know, obviously can't handle it, can't handle anything, they can't handle life. That's why they're perps. So they suck so bad at life. Their lives are so miserable, and they're so terrible at their own lives that they have to try and drag you down and make your life as miserable as theirs is, or, you know, make your life more miserable than theirs so they can feel good about themselves. It's kind of like the whole Jerry Springer effect here. You talk to people, normal people, back in the day when Jerry Springer was on. How can you even watch that show? And the most common answer you would get from people is, well, it makes me feel better about my own life, right? And I think you have a similar thing going on here. It's the Jerry Springer effect. These people are harassing and assailing and destroying other people's lives because it makes them feel better about their lives, because they're such pathetic peons. They're like Lilliputians. They have to tie someone else who's better than them down because, you know, otherwise we blow past them in life. And then it shows how pathetic they are and how unearned their positions and their station in life is. That's what I've come up with. Seems to me like that is a large, you know, driving factor for a lot of their low-level morons that they have doing the dirty work on the street, stalking somebody, harassing them when they're on their morning walk. You know, what kind of person does that? Yeah, she looked upstanding, you know, she looked like a normal person, right? She probably goes to work. She probably went to work and told people how, you know, she, you know, ran a terrorist out of her, you know, out of her neighborhood or some bullshit like that. Well, how she was doing her part to fight crime. Well, you know what? If I were a criminal, these people, I wouldn't have put up with this shit for this long. Obviously, I'm freaking going through great lengths to try and remain a law-abiding citizen despite the lawless actions of these idiots out here who are doing this shit to me. So, any misperceptions or misunderstandings about me being a criminal ought to be rectified, you know, ought to be put away after months of this shit, right? If somebody after months of this shit hasn't gone off on one of these assholes, then, you know, obviously they're not going to. So, time to move on and quit harassing them on their morning walks. Actually, this event struck me as weird, just something really strange about it at the time. You know, like I didn't really understand it as it was happening. That everything I've talked about so far is what was going through my head. But since I've had time to sit back and actually reflect on what was occurring and kind of replay the memory in my mind, it strikes me that this was an extremely unusual perp contact. Because normally they don't approach you. I mean, they stalk you from a distance. They drive by your house. You know, they're in your face to a certain degree, but they don't pull up to you and roll their window down. So I'm wondering if there was more to this than I initially thought. Something about the way she drove by and waved at me seemed kind of odd to me. Like, she was overly friendly for a perp, and I kind of blew her off, right? So maybe, you know, maybe my blowing her off presented a challenge in the mind of a middle-aged woman who's, you know, around her sexual peak, and she saw it as a challenge. She didn't like getting the kiss off, and so she pulled back around to try to approach me, get me to, I don't know, open up to her. I may feel like I'm a prisoner of war, and my, you know, this might be weighing on me and breaking me down over time, but I'm still appealing. So, you know, maybe she saw me walking by and she decided to do a little extracurricular, you know, a little bit of extra duty, go above and beyond, try and approach me and see if she could seduce me. But I gave her such a cold reception that it really pissed her off. And so she then used her perp powers to harass me. Because, yeah, she drives by the first time, and she waves to me and smiles and was really pretty friendly, it seemed. But since I have such a aversion to people driving around in red cars these days, especially when they tend to appear and be coming and going in a manner that coincides with my comings and goings, I don't really like it. So I wasn't as friendly as a normal neighbor would have been in that situation and waved back. And so maybe it presented a challenge, and she decided to view it as a challenge and see if she could, you know, up the stakes a little bit, and came back, asked me if I was lost, and hoping I would say something friendly, because she was pretty friendly at that point in time too, right? And I was kind of rude. I said, "No, I'm not lost. Are you?" And then at that point in time, she's wondering if I live around here, and maybe she's wondering if I live around here, if she can come to my place or what. I mean, it just seems to me that this was there was a totally different flavor and feel to this perp contact than I've ever had before, and I think it might have been unique to the person that in which I was dealing, who might have some marriage issues, or I don't know, maybe she's a nymphomaniac, who knows. All I know is it's really creepy the way she acted when I did nothing more than mind my own business and tell her that I wanted her to mind her own business. Following me for an hour like that, the cops never did show up, so I don't know what she was driving at. She's just letting me know, well, something about it seems like the way that somebody who had just been rejected and can't handle rejection very well might act. So I'm wondering if potentially, if what I'm dealing with here is a perp cougar, the cougar perp. Strikes me that I've seen this person on a number of occasions drive by my house, or, you know, pull out at the same time I'm pulling out. And maybe she wanted to be a little more friendly with me, and maybe there are some other reasons for that as well, like, you know, trying to get me to do something stupid to destroy the relationship I do have. I'm not interested. I would never be with a perp. I could never, I mean, that would be the, for me to ever bed down with a perp would be, aside from the fact that I'm already with somebody and I'm committed, for me, bedding down with a perp would be like the ultimate in depravity. Be the worst thing I could do. I wouldn't be able to look myself in the face. You know, I'd be scrubbing myself in the shower for several hours trying to wash off that dirty feeling that I would have after doing something like that. So no, I would never get with a perp, especially a middle-aged perp who wears too much makeup and can't handle rejection and has personality problems to that high of a degree that she would follow somebody who tells her to mind her own business for an hour, just over an hour. It was just, it's just ridiculous. So, yeah, I think this may have been the, been an attack of a cougar on an unsuspecting target. I guess maybe they feel like after they've beaten us down to such a degree that we're pliable and can be manipulated and they can get whatever they want from us and we have no right to say no or mind your own business to them. It's just, it's creepy, creepy stalker behavior. You know, you'd expect this out of like a male stalker, but a female stalker seems a little weird. Someone needs to keep an eye on her and make sure she's not a sexual predator, because I'm definitely out of her age range, I would say. No way. No frickin' way.